Hello, this is going to be a short video just showing you a new respirator that I received. I say new, it's actually old. This is a Belgian respirator or gas mask, whatever you prefer to call it. It is the BEM-4GP. And these have been used by the Belgian military. I'm not entirely sure who designed it, but I think some company in Belgium decided to create one instead of using an original made by more well-established companies. But this one is kind of interesting in the sense that when you put a filter on, you can choose what direction you want the filter to be. So if I screw a filter on here, I've got it set as a classic left side, but you can make it go all the way down, which I find is very inconvenient because you can't put your head down very far. And you can also make it be on the right side. And why you would care about this is for people in the military who are using rifles and things, depending on if you're left-handed or right-handed, this might be in your way to try and scope a rifle. So in that case, you can put it to the other side, you know, and now you've got nothing blocking your ability to do what you need to do. One thing you need to know about these is, and pretty much most secondhand used respirators, is you need to wash them. You need to, I mean, with modern ones, I wouldn't do it with like World War I or World War II or anything, but submerge them in soapy water, warm soapy water, swish it around, make sure you allow, like scoop up the water and allow the water to come out whatever the exhale valve is multiple times to clean the valve. This particular respirator was leaking air. I would put it on, hold my hand over the intake valve, the intake port of the filter, breathe in, the mask would suck onto my face, but then it would come out and it would equalize. And when I would test it with banana oil, I'd open the bottle, put it here, do the pressure test while holding the bottle here, and the pressure, because it would be like this on my face, and it would go like that, and it would suck in air, so I could actually smell the banana oil very strong coming in through the exhale valve, which is a worst possible thing that you could imagine, because it means that unsafe air is getting directly into the mask. But once I cleaned it, it got rid of whatever gunk was in there. So like I say, you just make sure it drips through so you can see the water coming out of there, and also pour water onto it from this direction to kind of get the valve to both be open and fully closed. So you literally just pour the tap in on the outside as well. Also, something you should note is on the filter intake port here on the mask itself, the rubber gasket inside was loose. It actually came out and was flopping around. There is a valve in there which, when you breathe out, prevents the air from getting back into the filter, because when you breathe out, when you exhale, it's very there's a lot of water vapor in there, and that will clog up a filter a lot quicker than it would if that was blocked. So they always put valves in there. So if you get one of these, make sure that press around the outside on the rubber, or if it is loose, like mine was, pull it out carefully, wash it, and then press it back in fully, so it'll be seated properly. So this is the overall of it. It's got a nice full face piece here for the eyes. You will see scuff marks and things on it. It's not perfect. It does have a drinking tube system, but A, I don't have the necessary bits for it, and I've been told that the drinking tube is very prone to be damaged. So you might want to have a look at this and always do a pressure check and make sure that your mask is not leaking any unsafe air by having something really smelly in front of it, either isoamyl acetate, I think it's called, which is the banana oil, or you could spray deodorant in large quantities and do the pressure test. So Let's have a look at what it looks like on. Okay, so here's what it looks like on. It does have a speech diaphragm system built into it, but I'll warn you, the more you talk with respirators, particularly this one for some reason, the more it kind of is wearing on your jaw. It kind of makes you ache. So, two straps at the top. They need presetting to your head. Got two at the side here. These also need presetting. And to do that, you just flick this plastic thing out. Pull it and set it how you need it, and then flick it back in again. These bottom two, they aren't preset. When you take this off, you just pull this tab and it goes slack, and you just pull it to put it on. Another important thing to note, at the back there's a pull tab. When you put this on, you've got to make sure that these top two are close against the head. So, right now this is not tight enough. So, what you do is you pull the tab, which pulls the mask upwards and gets these tight, and when you pull it, it slackens this back part, so you can pull these to tighten them up properly. So therefore you get a proper seal around the entire mask. To do a pressure check, put your hand over the port and breathe in. And you should do that for some time and make sure that it's not leaking. Get some smelly stuff like banana oil, put it around. Can't smell it, so I'm going to put it at the exhale valve. And then do a pressure check, because if there's any fault with this, that will force in some of this smell, so that when I continue to breathe in after removing my hand, if I can smell it, I know there's a problem. And there was no smell. So since I've washed this, it's actually working correctly now. There's no intake through the outtake. So, there you go. If you found this interesting or useful, please hit like, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.